In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
A warm welcome to St. Mary the Virgin in Bathwick for this second Sunday of Easter. It's good to be with you as we come to greet the Lord together as he comes to us in word and in sacrament. And as he first, of course, appeared to those disciples following his resurrection, when they were hidden behind the doors, the locked doors through fear, Christ appeared among them to cast out their fear and to open their hearts to receive and know him. May our hearts be opened to receive and know the Lord. As we make room for the Lord in our lives once more, let us turn to him in penitence. In baptism we died with Christ, that as Christ was raised from the dead, we might walk in newness of life. Let us receive new life in him as we confess our sins in penitence and faith. Lord Jesus, you have conquered sin and death. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you call us to peace and joy in your presence. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are our hope and our salvation. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory be to God on high, and in earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee. We give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer.
Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us, for thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art the Most High in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty Father, you have given your only Son to die for our sins and to rise again for our justification. Grant us so to put away the leaven of malice and wickedness, that we may always serve you in pureness of living and truth, through the merits of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please do sit for our scripture readings.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The whole group of those who believed were of one heart and soul, and no one claimed private ownership of any possessions, but everything they owned was held in common. With great power the apostles gave their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. There was not a needy person among them, for as many as owned lands or houses sold them and brought the proceeds of what was sold. They laid it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to each as any had need. This is the word of the Lord.
Praise be to God.
The response to the psalm is, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. O give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. Let Israel now proclaim, his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron now proclaim, his mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord proclaim, his mercy endures forever.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord's right hand has triumphed. The right hand of the Lord raises up. I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvellous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it.
The epistle is from the first epistle general of John. We declare to you what was from the beginning, what we have heard, what we have seen with our eyes, what we have looked at and touched with our hands concerning the word of life. This life was revealed, and we have seen it and testified to it, and declare to you the eternal life that was with the Father and was revealed to us. We declare to you what we have seen and heard, so that you also may have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. We are writing these things so that our joy may be complete. This is the message we have heard from him and proclaim to you, that God is light, and in him there is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him while we are walking in darkness, we lie and do not do what is true. But if we walk in the light, as he himself is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he who is faithful and just will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. My little children, I am writing these things to you so that you may not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. And he is the atoning sacrifice for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. This is the word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. I am the first and the last, says the Lord, and the living one. I was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. When it was evening on the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger in the mark of the nails, and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe. Thomas answered him, My Lord and my God. Jesus said to him, Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe. Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing you may have life in his name. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please do take a seat. I almost managed to take my week of leave. I haven't had leave since I can't remember when, and I almost got to take a full week of leave, but then had to sort somebody else who was out on operations and had a little bit of a pastoral thing going on, and so I had to go back in a little bit and help out with that. But other than that, I've been very good, and I've actually taken a bit of leave. And it's been great to spend some time with my children where we've not had to do homeschooling. Do you know the difference, by the way, between my children and the Taliban when I was in Afghanistan? You could negotiate with the Taliban, it's quite true. Anyway, I took them, my children, on a bike ride. They've not been riding their bikes very long. They're only 7 and 5. He's only just turned 5. I don't know what it is about children, but if you tell them not to do something because it's going to be quite dangerous, it's like a red rag to a bull, isn't it? Don't go riding down that great big hill, you'll come off your bike. He did it anyway, he didn't come off his bike. And my heart was in my mouth as I saw this just turned 5-year-old on his little green bike approach the hill that I wouldn't run down, let alone cycle down, and just go full pelt down this hill, careless of what might be around and all the rest of it, and finding it hilariously funny, just enjoying the moment, just caught in the moment. Something about children, isn't there? They just seem to be completely fearless. Yes, there's things that will make them afraid, you know, fear of monsters under the bed or whatever it is, but on the whole, they have no fear whatsoever. I watched some children at the park behind our house where we live, and there are these very tall spindly trees, and these children were, you know, young children climbing this tree right to the top with no fear whatsoever. And part of me was thinking, those silly fools, they're going to fall down and break their necks if they're not careful. But then I also caught myself, I reminded myself when I was their age, I was no different. I was always climbing trees, so much so that my mum used to say to me every time, if you fall out of that tree and break your legs, don't come running to me. And I'd be like, how? But they have no fear. And it's a shame that we lose that fear. I don't know what it is that makes us lose that fear. Whether children are just naturally channeled not to have much fear, or conditioned, or it's just that when we become an adult, we become more aware of how dangerous the world can be. We get edges knocked off of us. We get hurt. We build up experience and memories of what it is to be hurt, and what it is, if we're being honest, to hurt other people. And all of those things make us feel fearful, if we're being honest. Fear is a very natural human condition. In our gospel reading this morning, we're told that the disciples are in fear. The disciples are meeting together, they're regrouping, if you like, they're in the house, and the doors are locked because of fear, we're told. And of course, their fear is that they will be caught. They've seen their Lord and Master put to his death, they've seen the price for daring to be a follower of Jesus Christ. And they are fearful. They are fearful. They are locked behind these doors, trying to shut the world out because they are fearful. It reminds me, when I was coming to the end of my curacy, I first went to look at a parish in Birmingham, and there were prison bar windows on the vicarage. I thought, that's interesting. And I was told they had so many break-ins that they had to put these prison bar windows on the vicarage to stop people from breaking in any longer. Well, there's not quite prison bar windows on this house, but the doors are locked, and they're locked because of fear. And when Jesus stands among them, he says, "Peace be with you." And then we're told that their fear is turned to joy. It's an invitation here. I want us to kind of move away this morning from the traditional Divine Mercy Sunday Gospel where we talk about Doubting Thomas and all the rest of it. And I want instead for us to concentrate on this image of the locked doors. Because doors aren't just physical. Sometimes doors are spiritual. And sometimes doors are about faith. Although this morning we're hearing and we're talking about physical doors, what are the other doors in our life? What are the doors that keep you in fear? What are the doors that prevent you from encountering with the world and encountering afresh our Lord Jesus Christ? What are the doors or the barriers that you put up, or I put up, that prevent us from that important interaction with the risen Lord Jesus and with the people that we are, at the end of the day, called to go out and speak of about this good news of the gospel? There can be all sorts of things that hardwire us, all sorts of things that make us defensive, all sorts of things that lock us or lock our hearts behind doors. Yes, it can be fear, but it can be other things too. Old hurts or old wounds. Times when we've been very badly let down or very badly hurt. Times when we've hurt others. Times of hardship when we've had to muddle through the best we can. Grief. Painful memories, disappointment, ambition. They're just feelings of failure or experience of failure or what we might perceive to be failure. There are just so many things that can become doors to our heart being opened fully to the Lord and to his people. I think there's an invitation here this morning, not just to cast out doubt if we were to be concentrating on the figure of Thomas, but also to be concentrating on asking the Lord or responding to the Lord's invitation to be open to him, to be open to be changed, to be open to be challenged, to be open to be honest, to throw open those doors of our hearts that prevent the Lord from being truly present to us, or that prevent us from being truly present to others. Great risk in that, but the gospel is about risk. The gospel isn't about hiding away in fear. God will catch you whenever you fall or whenever you fall down. God will catch you, but you've got to jump first. The irony, of course, in the story this morning is that although the disciples were hiding away through fear, eventually, of course, they would be persecuted after all. They would, of course, lose their life for their faith in God and their faith in being a follower of Christ Jesus. But such was their faith, such was their hope, such was their realization what it meant to be open to the kingdom of God, not being locked away, not being fearful, not hiding away, but being open, responding to the presence of the Lord, and then wishing to make that presence known to others. Open your heart this morning. Take the risk. God will catch you. But first you need to open up the doors of your heart and dare to step outside. Stand as we say together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us then pray for the needs of the world and of the Church, and let us thank God for his good.
Risen Lord, come stand among us. Awaken us to your presence. Open us to the gate of glory. Show us the path of life. Help us to know that you are with us now and always. Risen Lord, we pray for your church. For all those around the world who witness to your resurrection, praying especially for those who are fearful of persecution and those who are suffering because of their faith. We thank you that we live in a country where we can freely acknowledge you. Give us courage to live and speak out boldly of your love, especially to those who are dismissive or mocking. We pray for all who are in doubt and for all who are seeking you. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
As we pray for your world, we give thanks for the beauty of your creation, especially at this time of year. We bring to you all leaders and governments around the world. We ask that leaders may come together to seek peace and justice. We pray for people suffering war, persecution, starvation, and homelessness, thinking particularly of Syria, Yemen, Myanmar, and other countries that you have laid on our hearts but no longer reach the headlines. We pray too for the young people caught up in all the unrest in Northern Ireland. Show us, Lord, what you would have us do to help the plight of others. We pray too for our own government, that they may have wisdom to make the right decisions over the coming months with the COVID virus. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious,
Risen Lord, we bring to you our communities where we live, our homes and our neighbours. We pray for each other, the person sat next to us, or in front or behind. May we all know your constant presence and love in our lives, no matter what difficulties or suffering come our way. Fill our homes with power and joy, that we and all whom we love may live your resurrection life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
Risen Lord, we bring to you all those who especially need the power of your love today. mind, or spirit. Those who are despairing, lacking confidence, afraid to trust, those locked in by fear or guilt. Give strength to all who care for the sick in any way, and all who work in counselling and social work. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Risen Lord, we give you thanks for all who have gone before us, especially those who through their lives have taught us of your love. Today we pray, God of our lives, we give you thanks for the life of Prince Philip, for his love of our country, and for his devotion to duty. We entrust him now to your love and mercy. May he rest in peace. We also ask for your blessing and love on Elizabeth, our Queen, and all the royal family in the coming weeks and months ahead. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Risen Lord, after your resurrection, you came to your disciples through closed doors. May the doors of our hearts always be open to you, that we may know your guidance and companionship as we continue on our Christian pilgrimage. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen.
The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then they rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Thank you.
When you break bread, may we recognize you as the fire that burns within us, that we may bring light to your world.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our
God.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Almighty and Eternal Father. And in these days, be it to celebrate with joyful hearts the memory of your wonderful works. For by the mystery of his passion, Jesus Christ, your risen Son, has conquered the powers of death and hell, and restored in men and women the image of your glory. He has placed them once more in paradise, and opened to them the gate of life eternal. So in the joy of this Passover, earth and heaven resound with gladness, while angels and archangels and the powers of all creation sing forever the hymn of your glory.
Holy, 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 God of power, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of your holiness. Granted by the power of the Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ is God. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. So, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom, all who share this one bread and one cup, among them Philip, the Duke of Edinburgh, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, St. John, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen.
Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. to the live stream at home. I'm going to lead you in a prayer for making a spiritual communion that I invite you to make your own. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and as I desire, passionately desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my soul, so that I may unite myself wholly to you, now and forever. Amen. Please do, those of you who are here in person, please do keep those who are still isolating at home, or having to keep themselves safe at home, or whatever reason that they are having to be at home, please do keep them in your prayers and help them to know that they're not forgotten. Let us pray. Lord God, our Father, for our Saviour Jesus Christ, you have assured your children of eternal life, and in baptism have made us one with him. Deliver us from the death of sin, and raise us to new life in your love, in the shared fellowship of the Holy Spirit, by the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Publish the banns of marriage between Michael Robert Lisanti, single, the parish of St. Mary Redcliffe, and Francesca Cecilia Lazio Higgins, single also of that same parish, but with a qualifying connection to this parish. This is for the first time of asking. If anyone knows any just cause or impediment why these two persons may not be married, you are asked to declare it now. Going, going, gone. Strike one. There we are. Brilliant. I'll hand over to Nikki for the notices.
Thank you very much, Father Chris, for looking after us this morning. It's always lovely to have you here. Most of the notices are on the leaflet that you will have. Pattern services is as laid down, but on Wednesday our Mass here will be a requiem for His Royal Highness the Duke of Edinburgh. So if any of you would like to come along to that, you will be very welcome. Now I have some very good news and some bad news. The good news is that we have been approached by British Rail, who are doing some work locally, and they have asked if they can use our car park for the next 2 weekends. Now, the offer is too good for us to refuse, particularly at the time when we have lost so much of our income. So we have said yes, please, but it does mean that the parking will be slightly limited in our car park for the next 2 Sundays. Marcus will be here early in the morning to direct all parking and to make sure that everybody parks and so we get as many people in as possible. But if you could park locally around the church instead of trying to get into the car park, that would be a benefit as well. So thank you. And thank you to Marcus for negotiating this wonderful offer for us. At the back of the church you will find that there are blue envelopes for those of you who give your alms in a blue envelope, to save you writing your names and addresses on all of them. So if you usually use an envelope, please do have a look. They are on the table at the back. Thank you.
The Lord be with you. The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the eternal covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you, and remain with you always. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ, and the new year, and the Lord.
Thank you. do get it, and you're in the front. They can. Just the numbers. So much.